Good evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to St. Dominic's Catholic Church, and a special welcome to new parishioners and visitors. Before Mass begins, we'd like to inform you of some important guidelines and rules to be followed at all times. Please keep your mask on throughout Mass and only take it off when you receive the body of Christ. We understand that most of you are attending Mass as a family, however, you must still keep collection will be from the front and the middle of the church, and we ask that you keep a distance by paying attention to the markings on the floor. During the distribution of the Holy Communion, please adhere to the markings and receive the body of Christ on your hand. Singing is kept in the moment, so for now only 2 or 3 minutes of the choir will be singing. A special thank you to all the individuals, the families, volunteered and to assist us before and after Mass. Mass is only possible if everyone continues to bow. And during the sign of peace, when the sign of peace is offered, please do not to the words of each other. Thank you for your support and your understanding. We offer this Mass for thanksgiving to our Heavenly Father, Jose Carlos Diaz, R.I.P., Harlan Moon Diaz, R.I.P., Sylvia de Silva Diaz, R.I.P., Maria de Luz, Deluz Diaz, R.I.P., and for souls, especially those most in need. This weekend is the fourth Sunday of Easter, news of the Good Shepherd, and the servants this evening of Father Graham and Deacon Greg. Peace that.
Thank you.
reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Rulers of the people and elders, if we are being examined today concerning a good deed done to a cripple, by what means this man has been healed, be it known to you all, and to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him this man is standing before you." This is the stone which was rejected by you builders, but which has become the cornerstone. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. The word of the Lord. This pastoral song will be sung. Thank you.
Gospel according to John. At that time, Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He who is a hireling and not a shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. He flees because he is a hireling and cares nothing for the sheep. I am a good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me. As the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. And I am other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will heed my voice. So there will be one flock and one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This charge I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
An aggressive journalist once interviewed a mother of 10 children. He asked the mother, doesn't every child deserve the full love of its mother? Certainly, answered the mother. Is it possible to give such love to 10 children? Yes, said the mother. The reporter persisted. No one can be completely impartial. Truthfully, which one of your 10 children do you love the most? The mother answered, the one who is sick until he gets well. The one who is sad until she is happy. The one who is away until he comes home. The gospel we heard today is known as the Good Shepherd. A good shepherd cares for all his sheep, but has a special concern for the one in need, as does a good brother. That is not partiality, that is love. Today we celebrate Good Shepherd Sunday. Now I'd like us to see a good mother in the image of the Good Shepherd. A good shepherdess cares for the flock of her family with love. Today's Gospel notes three marks of the Good Shepherd. He lays down his life for his sheep. He does not work for pay. He knows his flock. That is true of the Good Shepherd. It is true of good matters. We reflect on these virtues from different perspectives. As Christians, we see them as gifts from our Lord. As children, we acknowledge them as blessings from our mother. And mothers ponder these as models for their own vocation. A good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep. A good shepherd does not work for pay, and the shepherd knows the sheep. I know mine, and mine know me. The use of the title friend for Judas is clearly an insult. It indicates the deep pain inflicted by a failure in friendship. When Judas led the soldiers to arrest Jesus at Gethsemane, Judas greeted Christ with a kiss of betrayal. Jesus said to him, "Friend, do what you have come for." Judas was offered friendship, but abused it. He was trusted, but was not trustworthy. No one can harm you more than those you trust. No one can disappoint you more than those you love. When the Gospel says that the Good Shepherd lays down his life for his sheep, it means, theologically, that Christ died for our sins. His death was our salvation. But it means more. It means that his life, not just his death, was given for us. His life was given in service to others and as a model for our own living. It is in this larger sense of laying down his life that Christ, the Good Shepherd, is an image of and a model for mothers. The Good Shepherdess lays down her life for her children in service and as an example. The Gospel further says that the Good Shepherd does not work for pay. The shepherd's motive is love, not personal gain. A mother with an infant is a remarkably good image of the Good Shepherd. Such a mother focuses all her attention and that of others on the child. One hardly notices the mother. All the attention is on the child. The only reward she seeks is the welfare of her child. The Good Shepherdess does not work for pay. You can pay for child care, and there are daycare centers everywhere nowadays. But no one believes that daycare center replaces the mothers. Mothers do not provide daycare, they provide life care. Caring for a lifetime. You cannot buy a mother's concern or care. If you could, few could afford it, even at the minimum wage, and without interest. Christ says of himself as the Good Shepherd, "I know mine, and mine know me." The instinct that a shepherd has for his flock is an image of the insight mothers have into their children. A mother often knows the mind of her child before the child does. Good children should try to reciprocate. I know mine, and mine know me. Too often, these noble thoughts of the good shepherd and the good mother are never adequately appreciated in the busy rush of life, but only in retrospect. How does one express gratitude effectively for the good shepherd and the good mother? By being a good shepherd ourselves to those who are in our care. By loving most the one who is sick until he is better. The one who is sad until she is happy. And the one who is away until he returns home. So, Jean, let us renew our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate in the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Strengthened by God's word and God's promises, we recall our needs and the needs of the church and the world.
In response to the many graces the Lord graciously gives us,
Lord graciously hear us.
For those who need our help, In Jesus' name, Peter healed the crippled man. May we too reach out to others in need and by our faith in Christ and his power to save and to save, bring healing and wholeness to our communities. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For a desire to live as children of God. God's love for us is so lavish that we have become God's children. May this understanding fill us with confidence to face the future with hope, helping us to overcome fear and despair in life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the leaders in the churches, with Jesus the Good Shepherd as their model, may the leaders in the churches be faithful in what they preach and teach about the purposes of God revealed in Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the unity in the Church of God, Jesus prayed for unity among those who follow the Good Shepherd. May we look for ways to be one flock, faithful disciples of the Holy One who laid down his life for the people. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the sick in our parish. We pray especially for Mary Shores, Nellie Shores, Simon Rogero, Annie Artero, Eva Simon, Wanda Talbot, Pat Shaver, Amanda Hill, Jennifer Zell, Teresa Jackson, Monique Murray, Lindsay van der Ven, Jewel, Neto, Nicole de Andrade, and Martin Simon Jr. We also pray for Pope Francis, all sick bishops, priests, deacons, nuns, brothers, and all religious, that they may experience the consolation healing power of Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. God of love, may we be faithful in our following of Jesus, the Good Shepherd, listening for his voice and following his way. We ask this through Jesus Christ.
Oh, Good. Oh,
not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, that the reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us pray to God this time of peace. Thank you.
It has come to our attention that the rosary that was offered on the statue of Mary at Grand Massing. If anyone knows of the whereabouts of it, kindly advise our parish secretary or return it back to its place. Please stand and bless you.
Good Lord, be with you. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. May he, by whose redeeming word you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living the right man on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down to you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Let us learn the peace and love of Christ our Lord.
Service with us, and the service by anybody else who contributed to the Mass. Thank you.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the hour of battle. Be our protection against the wickedness.